Good afternoon to everyone. My name is Shashank Shekhar. I am working as an assistant professor in Computer Science Department, ABES Engineering College. Today's topic is we will study bubble sort. Now, bubble sort is a sorting technique, or we can say it's a sorting algorithm which works by repeatedly comparing the adjacent elements. And if the adjacent elements are not in the correct order, we will swap the elements, right? So if we talk about bubble sort, first we will discuss about the algorithm. There is a list L, okay? There is a list L. L has some elements which are unsorted, right? So the elements are 55, 44, 33, 22 and 11, right? We will start a loop for I in range length of L. That will start from the very first element. I will be solving an example for your reference. Like we have taken the same list here, 55, 44, 33, 22, 11. We need to sort this list with the help of bubble sort. So what we'll do, we'll start a loop till the length of L. So we'll start from the very first element, that is 55. I will mark or I will give them indexing. So 55 is on 0th index, 44 is on 1st index, 33 is on 2nd index, then this is 3rd and then this is 4th. Okay, then we have started another loop for j in range length of L minus I minus 1. We will start another loop which starts from the 2nd element and goes till the last element, right? And we have said if L of j is greater than L of I plus 1, if the element present in the inner loop is greater than the element present in the outer loop, if it is greater than, then I will swap both the elements Lj and Lj plus 1 is equal to Lj plus 1 and Lj, and in the end I will get sorted list, right? So if I initiate pass 1 for this list, what I will do, I will start comparing 55 with 44, 44 with 33, 33 with 22 and 22 with 11. Okay, so start doing this. First we will start comparing 55 with 44, 44 is less than 55, so we will put here 45, we will put here 55, then the remaining list will remain the same. Okay, in the next step, what we'll do, we'll start comparing index one, first element with index second element. 44, we'll here, 44, then we'll swap these both elements as 33 is less than 55. So 33 will come here, 55 will go there, then 22 and 11. Okay. Then 44 will remain its own position, 33, and then we will start comparing 55 and 22. 22 will come here, 55 will be here, and then 11. And in the end step, we will compare 55 and 11. 11 and 55. So upon completing this whole process, this pass one, what has happened? The largest element in the list has reached to its position, that's 55. 55 is the largest position in this list. So 55 has reached its last position, that is last. So after pass 1, we will say that at least one element has been sorted, that is 55, which has reached to its position, right? Now we have this list with us. What we'll do, we'll now start pass 2. We'll start pass 2. Okay. Now we will start comparing 44 with 33, 33 is less than 44, we will swap it, 22, 11, 55, okay, then we will compare 44 and 22, 33 is sort, is own position, 22 is less than, so 22 will replace 44 and 44 will get replaced by 22, okay, So here we will write 44 1 and this is 55, and in the end we will compare the third element and the fourth element, like 11 and 44. They will be swapped as 11 is less than 44, right? So 33 here, 22, 11, 44 and 55. Now as we compare both 44 and 55, we will say that 44 is less than 55, so there is no need of swapping. 44 is already smaller than 55, so the last two elements are already sorted. After the completion of pass 2, we are assured that at least two elements are already on their sorted position, that are 44 and 55, right? Now we have list 33, 22, 11 and 44, 55. What we will do? We will take the last sorted list, that is 33, 22, 11, 44, 55, and repeat the same process in the past 3. We will start comparing the first two elements. 22 is less than 33. We will replace them. 33, 11, 44, 55. In the next step, we will now start comparing second and third element. 22 is already in its first position. 11, 33, 44 and 55. This is pass number 3. So what has happened after pass 3? The three elements 33, 44 and 55 have come their sorted position. Like in the last three elements, we are seeing that these three elements are already sorted, 33, 44 and 55. So as we start going with the pass, the elements will become sorted. In the pass 1, we have seen that 55 was sorted. In the pass 2, we have seen two elements, 44 and 55 are sorted. In the third pass, we have seen three elements are sorted. Now we will continue with this list and we will proceed for the pass 3, pass 4. So this is the list 22, 11, 33, 44, 55. We will start comparing first two elements, 11 and 22. 11 will come on its first position, swept by 22, 33, 44 and 55. This is my pass number 4. After completing the pass number 4, you are seeing that the list which I have taken initially was this list. 55, 44, 33, 22, 11, which was not sorted. After completion of pass 4, we have obtained this list, which is now a sorted list. The first element is the lowest element and the last element is the largest element. So what we have done in bubble sort, we had compared the adjacent elements, one and the other elements, and if the two elements are not sorted, if the first element is smaller or greater than the next element, we have swapped the elements. So after completion of all the four passes, we have got the sorted array. Now if we talk about the complexity of bubble sort, we will not go in deep into the how we get the complexity. I will just tell what is the complexity. So the complexity of bubble sort in every case, in best case, in worst case, or in average case, it is order of complexity of bubble sort is order of n square. This is order of n square in all the three cases, best case, worst case and average case. So this is all from the bubble sort. We have seen initially the algorithm that has been working on bubble sort. Then we have got the idea of bubble sort with the help of an example, and in the end we have seen complexity of bubble sort in all the three cases. Thank you.